With commercial flights largely empty of passengers, airlines are taking a bath financially, losing tens of billions of dollars combined. But they also are receiving billions in aid from the federal government. As part of that deal, they cannot lay off their employees before October. There are big questions about what happens in the months ahead. Southwest Airlines is the largest domestic carrier in the U.S. Gary Kelly is its CEO and chairman, and he joins us now. Gary Kelly, welcome to the NewsHour. So your bookings are way down. You're taking precautions with your planes, and yet Americans, most of them, still afraid to fly. What do you say to them?
Well, great to be with you, Judy, and again, thank you for having us. Well, it's a really tough time for the world, quite frankly, and I think people are very concerned about the pandemic. They're concerned about their health. Even if people want to travel and have the means to travel right now, in a lot of ways, there's nowhere to go, if you know what I mean, because the country's been on lockdown. So it's incumbent upon us, first of all, to keep air transportation available. We're essential, according to the federal government. We take that seriously. That's also a commitment out of the CARES Act, is that we continue to fly. So then we need to offer a very safe product, and that's what we're determined to do. We've encouraged the TSA to begin temperature scans, as an example. We're doing deep cleaning in the airport, on the airplanes. We're doing physical distancing at the airports, also on the airplanes. So there's a number of things that we're doing. I'm happy to go into those in more detail, but we just want to make the environment as safe as possible, not only for our customers, but also for our own employees.
And we see some of the images of what Southwest is doing, and yet people think about flying and they think about walking down the aisle. They think about how close passengers are to one another. You said you won't do away with middle seats, for example. I mean, how do you truly make an airplane, which is an enclosed space where people are going to be close together, feel safe right now?
Well, we'll use a multi-layered approach. The first thing is we're requiring all of our own employees to wear masks. We're also requiring our customers to wear masks. We're not going to remove middle seats, but we won't book so many reservations so that all the middle seats could be unoccupied, if that's what customers choose to do. We deep clean the airplanes between flights and also at night. I think, interestingly, we're using an electrostatic mister, which has an antimicrobial mist in it, which will adhere to surfaces and then kill the virus upon contact for up to 30 days. We've got hospital-grade HEPA air filters that keep the air clean and fresh on the airplane. So there's a number of things that we do, and we feel very confident about it being a safe environment.
But no matter how clean you make the plane, how disinfected, the passengers get on, and they bring whatever they bring with them. I think that's what has people concerned about flying. Is that a fear that you think can go away until there's a vaccine, which may be a year and a half or 2 years from now?
I think that remains to be seen. I don't think that it will take quite that long for people to become more confident to get out and go about their daily lives, travel being a part of that. But I think all of us should have an expectation that travel will return gradually, and that will be, I think, one deterrent. I do think this too shall pass. I do think that things will get back to normal, but you're right. I think we have to be confident with testing, with therapeutics, ultimately a vaccine. We're in a recession right now. Business travel will certainly be depressed, and probably for years. And I think we're in a low-fare environment. Southwest is a low-cost, low-fare airline, and it really fits our business model very well. So we're here to serve. We're an essential part of the, not just the U.S. economy, but worldwide economy. And we're going to do the best we can to take care of our people and serve our customers.
Is the airline industry going to survive? Is every airline company, in your view, going to make it?
This is the worst economic environment I've ever witnessed, and I've been in business a long time. I think it's the worst thing that's happened since the Great Depression. So it's hard to imagine that you won't see businesses shut their doors, well beyond just the airline industry. So I think all that remains to be seen. We've got a duty at Southwest to protect our company and protect our people's jobs, and we're determined to do that as best we can, do that with great service, keep our fares low, and obviously offer a very safe product. So that's our mission, and I feel like our folks are very much up to the task.
But how hard is it to do that, though, Gary Kelly, without, frankly, ending up laying people off? You've made a commitment it won't happen until the fall, but how can you, I mean, looking at the picture realistically, how do you avoid it?
Well, Judy, it's right now, it's way too early to know. I think I certainly recognize that there is a challenge. Right now, we're experiencing 15 to 20% load factors, which is well below what break-even cash flow is. So we certainly have our work cut out for us. The good news is we're seeing each week improve. The bottoming was early April. May looks like it will be a better month. Hopefully June better still. The bookings out in July look more encouraging. It's going to be a gradual process, but it's just too early to make that call. If things don't improve, clearly, we're going to have to radically restructure, but that's not something that we have to commit to at this point.
And can you say at this point how much more you need from the federal government, from the taxpayers?
Well, first of all, we came into this year very strong. We have the strongest balance sheet in the U.S. industry by far. We've got an investment grade credit rating. Our leverage was 24% in terms of the debt to total capital. We've raised a significant amount of money and have over $15 billion in the bank as we speak. So we've got ample resources to see ourselves through a reasonable time horizon to fight our way through this challenge. So. The money that we got from the government so far was entirely dedicated to paying our employees, and it only covers 60 to 65% of the total payroll. We did apply for a government-secured loan program and have access to that, if we choose, through September the 30th. It's $2.8 billion. It's just a staggering amount of money that's required, not just for Southwest, but for the whole country. To get through this crisis. But in the end, I don't know exactly what it's going to take, but I do feel like, based on a reasonable outlook, a reasonably optimistic outlook for the next 12 months, that we've got what we need to see our way through.
Gary Kelly, CEO of Southwest Airlines, we certainly wish the best for you and for all of your employees. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Judy.